guys, it's Harley, and today I'm going to be doing a care video for the Marimo Moss Ball. I've wanted a Marimo Moss Ball since the beginning of my plant addiction, my plant obsession, we'll call it. And I finally got two a couple of months ago. With the holidays coming up, I thought that this would be a good video to do because I do think that the Marimo Moss Balls make an excellent gift, especially for like children that want a pet and want to care for something, but you don't want to get an actual pet. Let's just get into it. So first things first, the Marimo Moss Balls are actually a form of algae. They grow 5 millimeters per year, so very, very slow growers, and they are native to, cannot remember all this information. They're native to freshwater lakes of Estonia, Iceland, Scotland, Japan, and Australia. They are known to grow between 8 to 12 inches in diameter, which that's like actually really big. Wow, I want one that big, but. And they are also known to live to be well over 100 years old. Family heirloom. So they will outlive us. All right, so into the care needs of the Marimo Moss Ball. As far as lighting goes, they do need low indirect light. Too much light and they will turn brown. Not only that, but if they're getting too much light, their water also heats up more quickly and they do need very cold water. The very bottom of lakes are extremely cold. If you do happen to give it too much light, they will begin to turn brown and get kind of smelly. It's not too like potent of a smell, but you will notice it if you pull them out of the water to inspect them. If you do see the browning, you can just put them in colder water and move it into lower light, and that may resolve the brown problem on its own. It usually will go back to green on its own, but if not, then you can just add a little pinch of aquarium sea salt into your Marimo enclosure and it will go back to green. So I change my Marimo Moss Ball water every few weeks, kind of depending. So before I change the water, I'll fill up a pitcher with just regular tap water and I'll let it sit out in my house for 24 hours so that all of the chemicals, tap water chemicals, will dissipate out. Dump out the old water, pour in the new water, and yeah, that seems to be a really good system. I haven't had any problems with that. If you notice your water keeps getting warm really quickly, you can put them in the fridge overnight and it'll cool down the water and they actually really like that. I do that every few days, maybe a couple times a week. As for the round shape of the Marimo ball, you have two options to keep them that way. Down at the bottom of lakes, of course, there are current that rolls them around the bottom of the lake, so they keep their rounded shape. They're never really staying still, so that's why they're so round out there. To keep them indoors, we do have to take some preventative measures to keep them in their round shape, otherwise they will flatten out. So the first thing you can do is every time you walk by your Marimo enclosure, you could give the water a little stir to move them around and just kind of make sure that they're not sitting on the same side at all times. Otherwise the algae will start to grow out instead of around. Or you can also take the Marimos out of the water and massage them in between your palms to help keep the rounded shape. Just be sure to be very gentle with this because the Marimo balls can break apart if you're too aggressive about it. I just make sure to stir mine anytime I walk in or out of my house. It's a good way to remember to stir the thing. The last question people seem to have about Marimo balls is if they can be in fish tanks, and the answer is yes, they can be in freshwater fish tanks. They can't be in salt water, otherwise that'll ruin the Marimo balls. The one thing you have to be careful of about keeping them in a fish tank is, although it is really good for the water, it filters out toxic nitrates on its own. You do have to worry about the fish pecking at it. So what I would recommend doing is just popping it in your tank and kind of keeping an eye on it for the first few hours, seeing if the fish ignore it or if they're pecking at it, because so much pecking and your Marimo ball is going to dissolve. So if you're okay with that, then that's up to you. They are okay in freshwater tanks. Long story short, I can never stop talking. I think that's pretty much everything about the Marimo ball care. I really like Marimo moss balls. When there's super unique plants like that, they normally have crazy care needs or care requirements, and it's like a 24-hour job to keep them alive. But with the Marimo ball, they're very self-sufficient. Not too much goes into it, just a few things to remember here and there. I would love to know if you have a Marimo ball at home, and if you have any extra tips or tricks, please leave them in the comments section. I'm sure I forgot something. I tend to forget things, so I would appreciate you leaving that information in the comments section below. Thank you so much for watching. I will see my next one. Bye!